Happy Mother's Day. I love you, Mom.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom. Love you.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day. We love you.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day, Mommy. We love you.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom. Love you.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
I love you, Mama.
Happy Mother's Day, Mommy. I love you.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom. We love you.
Happy Mother's Day, Mommy. I love you.
There you go.
Love you.
Happy Mother's Day. We love you.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom. I love you.
Happy Mother's Day to the best mom ever.
Good morning and welcome to Grace Point at Home and Happy Mother's Day. We extend a thank you and a welcome to all the mothers joining us.
And if you're a visitor today, we're so glad that you're here. We'd love you to go to our website and to click the I'm New button that you'll see there on the screen.
Just a reminder, since today is Mother's Day, we wanted to do something special. We've got a food truck, Tortilla, coming to the Grace Point parking lot from 11 to 1:30. You can still jump online and place an order for that.
Now's the time in our service where we want to remind you about online giving. And we're so encouraged by how that giving has been going. In the middle of this time of uncertainty and unsteadiness, the Grace Point family gave more in April than any other month in the last year and a half. Praise God for what we are doing. Let's pray.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for this time to honor our moms, and thank you for putting us into families, moms and dads and grandparents and people that care about us. We thank you for our children. Thank you for how they've stepped up and done good things during this quarantine. Pray for all the graduates who are graduating from either first grade or second grade or high school or college. Please bless them and let them know, Lord, that you have a direction for their lives. Thank you for the moms who have worked so hard to make things work in this new time we're having in this world. Thank you for just blessing us with good weather and a church to call our own. In Jesus' name, amen.
Well, let's praise God a little bit this morning. Let's sing.
Now the darkness fades into new beginnings as we lift our eyes to a hope beyond. Our creation waits with an expectation to declare the reign of the Lord our God. Let's sing that again. When the darkness fades to new beginnings, as we lift our eyes to a hope beyond. Our creation waits with an expectation to declare the reign of the Lord our God. We will not be moved when the earth gives way, for the risen one is overcome. And for every fear, there's an empty grave, for the risen one has overcome. And now the silence breaks in the name of Jesus, as the heavens cry that the earth responds. Our creation shouts with a voice of triumph to declare the reign of the Lord our God.
sing together. He shall reign forever.
He shall reign forever. Strongholds now surrender, for the Lord our God is overcome. Who can be against us? Jesus, our defender. He is Lord, and he has overcome. He shall reign forever. Strongholds now surrender, for the Lord our God has overcome. Who can be against us? Jesus, our defender. He is Lord, and he has overcome. We will not be moved when the earth gives way, for the risen one has overcome. And for every fear, there's an empty grave. For the risen one has overcome. We will not be moved when the earth gives way. For the risen one has overcome. And for every there's an empty grave, for the risen one has overcome.
Drop by to check on Mama for a minute. I could hear her humming a tune through the screen door in the kitchen. She was putting the final touches on a homemade pecan pie. And just like always, I'm right on time. Little game of guess who, and I got a hug. Said, you know me, Mama, I've been hitting it hard, running like crazy. But I don't want to bore you with that same old nothing's new. I'd rather just fold up this chair and get caught up on you. Ain't it funny how it all comes back around? It's all about, yeah, I'm just slowing down, get my feet back on the ground. That minute turned into an hour before I knew it. I got my fill on pie and how everybody's doing. I used to look for every reason in the world to hit that road. And she said, you want another cup of coffee? I said, yeah, I'll take one more. Ain't it funny how it all comes back around? Get my feet back up.
Good morning, Grace Point, and happy Mother's Day to all the mothers that are out there. I'm here at High Banks Park. This is one of my favorite parks, probably because it's so close to my house. When I've had enough Zoom meetings in a day and I need some fresh air, I go out my back door, I cross Powell Road, and I come in the back entrance of High Banks. And before I know it, I'm lost in one of these amazing paths over here at High Banks. And I just get lost in the beauty that God made. I think beauty is one of the missed graces that God gives us. It kind of heals our soul when we see His beauty. I like the quiet paths, but I also like when I hear the giggles of children, the little squeals from kids as their mom is chasing them around or their dad is chasing them around. I've been coming over here a little bit more in the last few weeks because many of you probably know by now, but a couple of weeks ago we said goodbye to my wife's stepdad, Jim, up in Toledo, 79 years old, and he died of this COVID-19. It was sudden, it was sad. And we went up and the funeral was outdoors at the cemetery, and then we went over to my mother-in-law's driveway, and we set up in lawn chairs in a circle 6 feet from one another and wore masks. And we talked about Jim's life. We talked about his legacy. We talked about the important things in life. And my mother-in-law's nickname we've had for years is Punkin. That's a story for another time. But Punkin shared something that day that I hope I never forget. She told us, all of the grandkids, great-grandkids, all around, she said, it's easy to miss the important things in life when you're chasing after the urgent ones. Let me say that again. It's easy to miss the important things in life when you're chasing after the urgent ones. Punkin and Jim, they've been so good to us through the years. They drive down here to Columbus to one of the grandkids' houses every time it's Christmas or it's a birthday, And she's always interested in the gifts that the kids get, usually the ones she sends money for us to buy. And the kids are always wanting these electronic gadgets, you know, a new laptop or a new tablet or a new smartphone or an Apple Watch or something. And they show them to Punkin, and they say, Punkin, this helps us be in constant contact with our friends. And Shaq's all interested. Oh, that's wonderful. And then they try to convince her to get one. Punkin, if you got one, we could be Facebook friends, and we could send you emails back and forth, and we can stay in better touch. And she just laughs and says, no, I'm too old for that. Truth be told, Punkin's never had a computer. She's never had Wi-Fi in her house. She's never had a smartphone. 10 years ago, we convinced her to get her first electronic gadget. It was a mobile phone. It was a flip phone. And the reason was, is every time they drive to Columbus, inevitably they get lost going to one of the grandkids' house. And this way she could call us if she got lost. Well, anyway, Punkin was always celebrating with the kids. And she'd say to us, listen, if I got one of those gadgets, it would probably distract me from things that are more important in my life, like studying my Bible or sitting in my rocker and talking and listening to Jesus or watching reruns of Murder, She Wrote or playing Phase 10 with Jim, which, if you've ever played that, that's a long, long game. I've been thinking about Punkin as I've been reading through the daily readings we're doing for Feasting on the Word. Here at Grace Point, we're reading through the Bible in a year, and I think today is the day that we were reading in the Gospel of Luke. And in the Gospel of Luke, in chapter 10, there's a story that Luke includes that's not found anywhere else in the Bible. It's a story of Jesus staying at the home of these two sisters, Martha and Mary. And Martha is described as being all anxious and bothered and preoccupied by preparing the house, by preparing a meal for this visiting distinguished rabbi Jesus. And Mary is described as sitting at Jesus' feet and just listening to his heart. As you read the story, it says that Martha goes to Jesus and says, would you chew out my sister? Because she's not helping out. She's not carrying her weight. And Jesus, like, gently says to Martha, Martha, What's important to me right now is what Mary's doing. What's necessary is what Mary's doing. I'm not gonna take that away from her. And then the story kind of ends. But if you can learn a little bit more about that story by knowing where was Jesus headed when he stayed at their house. Jesus was heading to Jerusalem to be crucified. And right outside the walled city of Jerusalem was this small village of Bethany where Martha and Mary lived. So he went there to be around some people that were safe, some people that were interested. Did he really need a fancy meal? No. Did he really need a guest-perfect house to stay in? No. He needed a friend that was close and safe and would listen to his heart as he kind of processed all that he was about to face. Sometimes when we show kindness to people, we show kindness in the way that we think that they need it. And when they don't appreciate it, we get bent out of shape. Maybe the better way to show kindness is to find out what the person might want or what a person might need and then go from there. What Jesus needed was what Mary was offering. I love being here when I see women playing with their children, moms hanging out with their kids, chasing them around the park, and it makes me think, what did they say no to? What urgent things did they say no to in order to say yes to these important things? Sometimes I see the moms put their kids down with some Happy Meal or something, and then they go to the other side of the bench, and I see them opening up their Bible and just breathing deeply the presence of Christ that's in this beautiful place. And I just wonder, what did they say no to? What loads of laundry or parts of the house to clean did they say no to? What French fries did they leave at the bottom of their minivan? What clients did they have to say no to be able to say yes to these important things like playing with their kids or being with Christ? How many times did she say no to participate in the Achiever of the Month Club at work? How many times did she not do the urgent things, chase after the urgent things in order to do the important things? Recently, we gave Pumpkin, my mother-in-law, a couple weeks ago after Jim died, her first new technology gadget in 10 years. We gave her something that's called a GrandPad. Have you ever heard of this thing? It's kind of like an iPad, but there's just 6 apps, and it's a closed system, meaning that the only contacts she has in it are people that have been approved by the administrators, Kelly and I. You can video chat with somebody, you can email with somebody, you can post pictures and receive videos and pictures that people in your contacts post. You can play a few games, you can listen to some music, and she absolutely loves this GrandPad. All of the grandkids and the great-grandkids are sending every day a video and a picture, and when Pumpkin gets the notification that there's a new thing is this chime thing. It also chimes the administrator, so I'm kind of sick of it already, but she just loves it, and she opens it up, and then a couple times a day somebody wants to video chat with Pumpkin, and we're all realizing that she's going through this loneliness, this grief with Jim not around anymore. And every time I talk to her, I say, how's the GrandPad going? And she says, it's just wonderful. I absolutely love it. Thank you so much. And I'm so pleased that it's helping her and she's going through this grief. But there's a little part of me that is a little nervous about the GrandPad. And that little part of me is, I don't want her to be chasing after these urgent notifications and chimes and miss out on the important things. Like when she goes down into her rocker and listens to God's voice when she opens her Bible and studies it. But I think I know Pumpkin well enough. For as long as I've known her, she knows how to shut down everything around her, even if there's guests in the house, and go spend time with Jesus. And so I don't think she's going to have a problem of closing down the grandpan and going in and doing the important things. It's easy to miss the important things when you're chasing after the urgent things. So may you, as you are slowly getting back into your routine of chasing after urgent things, as you get back into your routine at work, as you get back into your routine at school or wherever, may you not miss the important things because you're starting to chase the urgent ones. And may you be found at the feet of Jesus, listening to what's on his heart. Happy Mother's Day, and we'll see you next week. But let me pray for us now. God, as I'm in the middle of this beautiful place at High Banks, and I'm thinking about all the moms who have said no to the urgent to say yes to the important, may you guide these moms. May you protect these moms. Would you remind these moms of the important things? Would you remind us all how easy it is to miss the important things when we're chasing after the urgent ones? And may we be found, Lord, at your feet regularly, listening to your hearts. And when we're helping, wanting to help, show kindness to other people, may we first learn what is it that they need, what is it they want, and go from there. We pray your blessing over our week. And all God's people said, amen. See you next week, everybody.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Jesus, a name above every other name. Jesus, the only one that could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe, we live for you. Oh, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
Sing Jesus again.
Jesus, a name above every other name. Jesus, the only one they could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe, we live for you. Oh, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show your heart and lead me in your love.
us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, Father God, we pray to you that we would want you and the things of you and your presence that much, that we would view your presence as that sweet, that we would view your will, your way for our life above any other. And though sometimes some really good things distract us, some really good things pull us away and fight for our attention, that through those good things, God, you're speaking to us, you're bringing us back in like a good shepherd, and that though sometimes there's some really negative things, some really destructive things that pull for our attention, God, you're using those things to pull us back to you, to your will, your way for our lives. We thank you that we get to pray to you, even through a computer screen like this, God, that we get to do this. We can pray together as your people. And we pray in your name. Amen. Well, I'm so glad that you joined us today for Grace Point at Home. I want to remind you to visit our website, gracepoint.cc, and you'll be able to find messages for our kids on there, for our students, and lots of other resources. And if you're new, we'd love to hear from you. We'll see you next week for Grace Point at Home.